I'm here on the banks of Little Cliff Pond in Nickerson State Park to welcome small business coach Helen Kaczynski to the show. One of the reasons that we're here is because this is where Helen often does some of her meetings, because it's so wonderful, beautiful, and calm, as you can see. So welcome, Helen.
Thank you, Kyle. It's great to be here.
Great. Thank you. When did you start Better Than Ever Coaching?
Better Than Ever Coaching was started in 2005 part-time, and then I went full-time in 2006.
Good for you. That's great. And at this time of year in Massachusetts, when someone says coach, I think everyone starts to think football. I mean, they think the New England Patriots, but they also think about Dawson High School and the new Monomoy Sharks and all of that stuff. So, but that's coaching. But what kind of coaching, how would you define just small business coaching?
Well, it's very different than football or soccer. It's interesting. Some people say, oh, what kind of coach are you? And I always say, football, because they look at me and here's this petite woman. But small business coaching is much different. In football, you have a coach who's the expert and he tells you the plays and all that. Coaching is very different. Coaching is a partnership with the coach and the client, and the coach really follows the lead of the client. The client is the driver. And a simple explanation of what coaching is that the client is at point A and they want to be at point B. Now, even if they don't know point B, they work with the coach and figure out, get that clarity of what point B is. And then they define how they want to get there, what the steps are. And one would think that, oh, it's going to be a straight line. Nope. It's curlicues. It's back and forth. But the coach is holding that vision of what that person said they wanted to do. And that's one of the roles of a coach. A coach also is an accountability partner. So they say they want to do these steps. Well, checking in with them, making sure that they've made that progress. Also checking in to make sure that point B is where they really want to be. Sometimes that changes. Sometimes it goes here or it goes over here. And so working with them to make sure that that's really what they want. A coach is also a trusted confidant and a sounding board and a cheerleader and also that objective voice. And with the small business owners, and that small business of small business coaching is really the clientele I serve, they often don't have a sounding board or a trusted confidant. They can't go to their staff and say, oh, I'm thinking of retiring too early, because, oh, then people get nervous and all kinds of things happen. So having a coach to work with through some of these changes, and oftentimes it's expansion of business. It's they want to create like an enterprise, or they do want to create an exit strategy.
Yeah, with micro businesses that we have in Brewster and mostly on the Lower Cape, a lot of times it's just one person in the business. And you're right, not having somebody who you can go and talk to in a confidential way and be honest and open, it can get really painful at times. It's like, what am I going to do about this problem that I'm facing?
Right.
Yeah, so having somebody to turn to is great. How long does a typical client work with you?
Well, each client is unique. So my very first client, I still work with her. Because she came to me years ago because she wanted to change jobs. And then she decided to stay in that job and work on her management skills. And so we have just kept working together. And there's other clients that we get to point B and they say, this is great. I'm all set and I'm done. And they may or may not come back. They may come back 2 years later with something else that they want to work on. Maybe they're stuck or they have an idea and they're just not sure what to do with it.
Yeah. So how did you get into this field?
Well, that's kind of an interesting journey. I have a degree in elementary ed. When I got out of school, there were no jobs. So I taught at a preschool for a year. My father said, come on, technology, get into computers. So I say I fell into computers, and I spent close to 25 years in computers.
Oh, my goodness.
I worked at Fidelity Investments for close to 20 years. I did everything from programming, web design, managed projects that were million-dollar projects, and my last stint was IT audit. And to keep Fidelity safe and all their systems safe. We want to keep your money safe. And I knew that that wasn't what I wanted to do. And I kept trying to find it. That's why I did so many different jobs at Fidelity. And I was homesick one day and I was watching Oprah. And Cheryl Richardson, who is one of the pioneers in coaching, was on. And I thought, I'd love to do that. That sounds great. Well, it took me 6 years to then hire my own coach and figure out what I wanted to be when I grew up. And it turned out I wanted to be a coach.
That's great. I love that story. 25 years to get there. That's okay. That's
like, yeah. So much along the way. And a lot of the skills that I learned really help me work with my clients. So, they say the journey is, and just build on that.
So what kind of training did you go through for this?
I attended Coach U, which is a premier coaching school, and I did their first level of training and I did their advanced training. And I'm certified through Coach U. Another piece of it is the International Coach Federation has a certification. They're kind of our governing board, if you will. Yeah, because the government does not say, coaches, you must have this in order to practice. And so I'm certified through the International Coach Federation. They have three levels, and I'm at the second level. And that I had to do 750 hours of actual coaching. I had to have a certain number of hours of training. I did an impromptu coaching meeting with trained, certified coach, and they were looking for specific things for me to be at that level. So there were certain criteria. So the certification really can help people to distinguish that this is a coach as opposed to people just hanging shingles out there. I also am a trained equine guided educator. So I can use horses in coaching. I've been trained to do retreats, and I've been trained in two programs, Get Clients Now and Now What. So I'm facilitators for those as well.
That's really cool. Yeah, the Get Clients Now, you've offered that out to the business community several times over the last few years, and I hear it really works.
It does. Well, it's systematic, which is great, and it's something that you can pull off the shelf anytime. You can reuse it. That's the one thing I really like, and it's something that you really can use in your daily life and get results, which is so cool.
That's very cool. I love it. I know that we've helped you promote that program, and I hope you're getting lots of people through it. You've kind of described the typical client, and it's particularly in this area, the small business owner. How long have most of them been in business? That sort of thing.
Well, I work, as you mentioned, the micro, or I call them solopreneurs. I work with really small business owners, but not small in revenue, small in employees. I like the 1 to 25 or 50 employee. Mm-hmm. Some small business owners will work with up to 500 employees. So I like the smaller end of small business. They have been in business. The ones that I really love working with, they've been in business for a while, probably more than 5 years. They've already had that success, and now they're going, okay, so what's next? How do I keep this exciting and interesting for me? And they're very, the ones that I attract seem to be very charismatic, really go-getters, dedicated, enthusiastic small business owners. The other thing I want to bring up is I am not confined by geography. I work with most of my clients over the phone. So I've worked with people in Texas. I've worked with people in California, Massachusetts, Cape Cod, and even the Cape Codders. I work with over the phone often because it makes it so much easier in their business. They don't have to travel, take the time to travel, because small business owners are time strapped. So being able to pick up the phone, have our meeting, and then go back to their business is really
the little check-in time, the periodic stuff. I did mention at the beginning that this is one of your favorite sites to have meetings. And why is that?
Well, I run women's walking retreats here. I run them in the fall and the spring. The Paradise Path focuses on creating a dream life, and the Cool, Calm, and Collected is how to stay sane when your life gets crazy. And I do it with small groups, and we actually walk around Little Cliff Pond, and we have different meeting points. There's a beach at the end of this, and we end up meeting there, and then we end up right in this area when we finish up. And it's amazing what getting out in nature, putting away all your electronics and connecting with people, it's amazing what can happen and transpire. The ideas, the just the clarity that comes out of the retreats is it's just astounding.
Yeah, just even driving out here today was it's just so peaceful and so nice. And I was thinking this is why having a meeting, having a retreat out here is so special, because it's so beautiful. It makes you really appreciate what we have here on Cape Cod and our environment, which we all think is really important and special. And it's part of why our economy works. So that's right. So there are two questions that I ask everybody when they come on the show. What do you like least about being your own business owner?
That's a hard one for me, because I really like so many pieces of mine. I guess it's the busy work. So scheduling appointments or changing prices on my offerings, kind of those silly little things that aren't so silly that really need to get done, but feel like, oh, little chunks of time that I could be using coaching or developing a program or having fun. But I love coaching, so that's fun for me.
So we absolutely hear the enthusiasm you have for the work that you do. What do you like best about this?
The best part is when you're working with someone and they get the clarity that they need. The cartoons show the little light bulb above the head, but even when I'm on the phone, you can hear it, and it's just like they've got this nugget that now they can use and run with it, and that's so exciting.
That is cool. That's very cool. I know I work with boards of directors, and that it's really neat when the light bulb goes on. Oh, yeah. You're absolutely right. So what do you, outside of your coaching, what are some of the other things that you like to do?
Well, I love walking on the beach, the bay beaches. I live close by to one and just absolutely love to do that. And I'm an avid reader, too. So,
So what's the book on your nightstand?
Let's see. Well, Get Clients Now is actually right now, because I'm preparing for one of my programs, and it's a great book to reread. Let's see. Tribes. I just finished Tribes by Seth Godin, and that was really, really interesting. So I like that.
So a good tip on reading from Helen. Helen, this has been really terrific. It's been great to learn more about you and your background, and also to have a clearer understanding of what coaching is for a small business. I think that's really important for people to hear. It's not the football coach telling you what to do. It's you're exploring your own ideas and your own thoughts and being able to share them with someone who can help you get to the next step in what you're trying to do. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Kyle. I appreciate the opportunity.
And thank you for watching. Tune in again next month when we'll bring you more of the Best of Brewster.